Hi, I will now show you Protégé 5.0. This is an tool for ontology engineering developed by the Stanford University. And I will show you just a quick overview over the tabs and what you can do with it. Here we see we have the IRI, the International Resource Identifier. We could modify that by ontology, for example. Here we could add some annotations to our ontology. This is my new ontology, for example. And we can say that this is eligible. Here it's possible to add more prefixes or import external ontologies. Now I skip the entities view because it's more or less the same than the class view with just some different options regarding the properties. Here we can create class hierarchies. If we want to do something more, if we want to create more classes, we can use the tools class hierarchy. Here we could add a prefix and a suffix, but we just want to person. This is the owner of the pets. Add mouse, I don't know. And this is also very important. It's recommended to tick this field because usually all classes are disjoint by default. And now we can see we created some classes. Here it's possible to add object properties to classes that are, for example, relationships between classes, where, for example, that a person owns a pet. We could add this. And then we set domain is person. And range is some kind of pet. Data properties describe properties for that point to a literal, for example, that a pet has a name. Now we have some predefined annotation properties we can use within Protégé. And here we could add individuals, like we could add a cat here, and this is an individual of the type cat. What's really great in Protégé 5.0 is that the always works per default on Mac, because I think it wasn't the case in the last version, there was some kind of problem. And we have a nice graphical overview here and can arrange the ontology with several options. Yeah. Finally, you could also, of course, make description logic queries or use the ontograph. That's another graphical visualization. You could compare two ontologies in this tab, and finally you have the Sparkle queries. The Sparkle queries, you can add queries. What's very important with Sparkle is at the beginning that you add the prefix for the current ontology, otherwise it usually doesn't work. So we copy this here And if we execute the default Sparkle query, of course we get all subjects where they are a subclass of some object. Okay, I hope you liked my short introduction, and if you want to learn more about Protégé, you could check the website protege.stanford.edu.